الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، from the pearls of the book of Allah سبحانه وتعالى، قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم: إن الذين يحادون الله ورسوله أولئك في الذلين، كتب الله ليغلبن أنا ورسولي، إن الله قوي عزيز. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitabihi al-kareem, those who oppose Allah and His Messenger, they will be amongst the lowest, meaning the most humiliated. Allah has decreed, verily it is I and my messengers who shall be victorious. Verily Allah is all-powerful, almighty. Imam Sa'di, rahimahullah ta'ala, says about this ayah, he says, this is a promise and a threat. A threat for those who oppose Allah and His Messenger through disbelief and sin, in that they will be defeated, humiliated, and will not earn the good end, nor will they raise a triumphant flag. It is a promise to those who believe in Allah and His messengers, alayhim salatu wasalam, and follow what the messengers, alayhim salatu wasalam, came with, thus becoming among Allah's victorious party. They will earn victory, triumph, and the upper hand in this life and the hereafter. This is a promise that shall never be broken or changed, because it is coming from the truthful, the all-able, the Almighty, who is never unable to do what He wills to do. Ahabati fillah, in this gem from the Book of Allah and from Imam Sa'di in his explanation, his tafsir, we see the importance of remaining faithful. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we rectify ourselves, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will aid us. And there's no doubt, with or without us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen will be aided. Will there be casualties? Yes. Are there casualties? Yes. But eventually, the Hizbullah, meaning the party of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those people who are obedient to Allah, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and aids and supports, because they're Ahli Iman, was Sunnah, that they're supported by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil and bless us to be from Ahli Iman wa Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'a wa Ahli Jannata Firdaus. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Nabiyyina Muhammad.